Thank you for calling CNN.
I'm Tracy. I'm calling from the foothills of Northern California. I'm calling because I've been sitting with the danger of living in California given the fires. We've been considering actually leaving our home, not wanting to spend summers filled with smoke. The big question I have is, if not here, where?
Tracy and her 5-year-old granddaughter live near the wildfires that have ripped across California in recent years.
My son, luckily, was visiting and staying with me for a while and woke me up at 2 o'clock in the morning and said, "Mom, I smell smoke, a lot of smoke." And I went outside and it was just thick. You couldn't breathe. The whole sky across the pond went red. And so I grabbed the baby at the time and the dog and a couple of important things, my laptop, and jumped in the truck and ran.
Her family evacuated safely and the house survived, but the worsening fires, which scientists link to the climate crisis, make Tracy worry about her granddaughter's future. She wants to leave.
I had always planned to live and die here. I didn't plan on moving again. You know, I'm lucky that I have a choice to go someplace else, but, you know, then the question becomes, well, where?
It's just a reality that some people are going to have no other option but to move. It's unfortunate, but it's a reality.
Nowhere is unaffected, but researchers like Jesse Keenan have started looking at places of so-called climate refuge, which may prove to be more resilient as humans continue to pollute the atmosphere and warm the climate.
Certainly this is on the scale of the Great Dust Bowl and the migration that came along with that. There's too many unknowns, but we do recognize that this is in the order of millions of people.
Keenan says there's one American city he believes is particularly well positioned to become a refuge for climate migrants like Tracy. That city? Duluth, Minnesota.
We are known as the San Francisco of the North. I'll let you decide if you think that's true.
I traveled to Duluth, and I did so a little skeptically. I've reported on climate migration for years, usually from locations like Honduras, Puerto Rico, the Marshall Islands, places where people are being pushed out of their home. Was there another and less visible migration already underway? One in which people are choosing sites of refuge?
You know, a handful of years ago, I would have thought, that's a one-off. It is much more common now.
Duluth is embracing the idea of itself as a climate safe haven.
It feels really sad to me that we are at a place and a stage that people are actually considering abandoning the history of who they've been, of who their family's been, of where they've lived, and actually choosing to leave that. And at the same time, if that means that people can find that and build that narrative for themselves here in Duluth, it's an extraordinary place, and we do want to be that for people.
The city's climate and geography are part of the reason that some scientists say Duluth will fare better than most. Duluth is known for its sub-zero temperatures, which are getting a little warmer. It's far from the coasts, and there's one other huge reason.
Lake Superior is the largest of the North American Great Lakes. It contains about 10% of the liquid fresh water on the planet. The shifts that we've seen in climate, some of them I think arguably make it a little more pleasant. Warmer winters is not entirely unwelcome.
Local indigenous leaders near Duluth are concerned that a wave of climate migrants could further degrade the land and threaten their rights.
If you think northern Minnesota is beautiful, you're right. We welcome you. If you are going to come here, then you need to support us as indigenous people so that your climate solution doesn't end up in our cultural and spiritual genocide. This is treaty area for the Fond du Lac Band. And once again, we are going to bear the brunt of colonization. These will be new colonizers coming to the area. they're going to come here for reasons that have nothing to do with anything that tribal people have done.
People have been moved and removed from land for centuries. And so this concept of adding that kind of historical trauma into the conversation just makes it very, very complicated.
If you're coming for the clean water, can we still promise you clean water with 50,000 or 100,000 more people? Can we promise we're going to have a quality school or, you know, an adaptable economy that meets everybody's needs? Don't kill the thing you love, do you know? And you can't stop individuals from doing it, but you can plan for it.
For now, Keenan and other researchers say many Americans are continuing to move toward the places that we know are becoming more dangerous. Toward the coast or toward the Southwest, for example, which is becoming more arid. But a few climate migrants are showing up in Duluth already.
Do you consider yourself a climate migrant?
Yeah, I do. I do. I think that's really, that's really hard to say, because I think on some level it sounds like we're giving up on California.
Jamie Alexander fled San Francisco with her husband and two children, unsure where to go, but certain that they couldn't stay for another wildfire season.
The 2018 campfire happened, and that really changed. That changed everything for me. Our home didn't feel habitable to us anymore.
They miss San Francisco, but Alexander says Duluth has welcomed her family, and she couldn't be more grateful.
We are all sort of in this unknown together. There's no guidebook for this, and I found that really disconcerting, but also I think it helps us see our shared humanity in all of this.
I called up Tracy, whose message launched this trip, to see what she would make of this.
What do you think about Duluth, Minnesota?
I'll go look. You know, maybe it's closer to San Francisco now than I realized. If so, that would be wonderful. Anywhere up north is cold, so it's not about the cold, it's really the culture.
She plans to move in the coming year.
I'm definitely going. I've decided we're going.
Still, she's not sure exactly where she'll go.
There's going to be a lot of work to be done no matter where that place is. So whether you stay or go, I think that, you know, the work is very similar that we all have to do and how we live independently and together.